We all know that Illustrator is the industry go-to program for flat sketching. That alone is reason enough to learn it, especially given how often flat sketches are used by designers. But there's actually quite a few other use cases for a fashion designer, and today I'm going to share five with you. Welcome or welcome back to my channel. My name is Mikhail Drew Pelham. I am a digital fashion specialist teaching digital fashion design and communication through my company, 383 Design Studio, as well as the Fashion Institute of Technology and various other universities. I talk about digital fashion software, design communication, and fashion entrepreneurship on this channel. So if that's something you're interested in, make sure you subscribe and hit the notification bell. Illustrator is quite a versatile program. In fact, one of the reasons it was so readily adopted in the early 2000s when we first started using Illustrator was because it was a tool that could be used by multiple teams. Your fashion designers could use it to sketch, your graphic designers could use it to design logos or graphic tees, the print designers could design prints, the marketing team, if they weren't using InDesign, could create layouts. And you might be using one license and one computer, but have various people sit down in front of that computer to get their jobs done. And as a fashion entrepreneur, you wear a lot of hats and also want to use as many, or should I say as few, digital apps as possible that can improve your productivity. So no matter what, Illustrator should definitely be a part of your fashion design software mix. So what else can Illustrator do? One of our favorite things to talk about on this channel, and in my Creating a Tech Pack course, I recommend using Excel or Google Sheets, mostly because once you get to that BOM and the spec sheets, it's so much easier. However, I've had plenty of other designers ask about just doing the Tech Pack in Illustrator. And honestly, I did it for many years, up until my last corporate job, actually. And the logic here makes sense. You're already in the program flat sketching, so why not just stay there to complete your tech pack? I do suggest if you're going to do this, you create a template. I have one that I've used for years and provide access to it in my course so that if you decide that you'd prefer to do your tech pack there instead of Excel or Google Sheets, you can do all the same steps taught in the course just in Illustrator. And although I think I'd still choose using Excel or Google Sheets over going back to creating tech packs in Illustrator, there is absolutely nothing wrong with doing them that way. It's actually quite common. If you're not using a tool like NeGraphics or maybe Kaleido, most textile designers are creating their prints in either Photoshop or Illustrator. And honestly, for a very long time, most of the textile designers I've met were using Photoshop, and they really weren't using Illustrator as much unless they were doing something very clean or geometric, very simple, maybe stripes or plaids. But in recent years, I've met more textile designers whose main program is Illustrator, which is pretty amazing. Although I think Photoshop still handles the more painterly prints better, there are some more painterly things that can be done in Illustrator. But what I appreciate most is the pattern options panel, which helps you create a repeat so much more efficiently. You can start by choosing full or half drop. And then because it shows your repeating tile across the screen, it's so much easier to create the repeat. I also love the recolor artwork options. There's also now a generative recolor feature. And you can also create what's called an art production sheet, basically a one-page tech pack for your artwork, right in Illustrator as well. If you want to learn more about any of these functions, you can check out these videos on my channel. They'll each take you step by step through each of the things I previously spoken about, the recolor artwork, generative recolor, creating a print repeat, and how to create the art production sheet. Now, again, if I had a choice, I would choose to make patterns in a 3D software like Browseware, Clo3D, or Style3D. However, there are many of us who just don't have access to 3D. 3D is amazing, but between the expense of the software and hardware upgrade, it can get pretty pricey. But you can create patterns in Illustrator, and luckily there are also plenty of designers who have created additional assets to support you in doing this. A quick internet search or even an Etsy search will give you lots of options of creators selling blocks, French curve rulers, and more, all compatible with Illustrator. And there are also lots of free and for sale patterns that are saved as PDF documents and can be opened and edited in Illustrator. So you don't even really have to start from scratch or even a block if you don't want to. If you're interested in learning more about how to create patterns in Illustrator, I highly suggest you check out Dominique Alyse Studios. She has an awesome YouTube channel and some amazing tutorials showing how she creates patterns in Illustrator. Illustrator was originally created for graphic designers, and so it makes sense that you can design and lay out embroidery or embellishments in the program. I'm going to reference Dominique Alyse Studios again for this one. She designs luxury evening wear, so she uses Illustrator a lot for her embroidery and beading layouts. She has an amazing free download, which I'll link to in the description if anyone's interested, of beads from circle, marquise, or square rhinestones to bugle beads to various faceted beads. And they're all vector-based and ready to use in Illustrator as you design the layout of your next beaded creation to put on your gown or even a casual top that you just want to embellish because you're feeling extra. Last thing we're going to talk about today are art production sheets. I mentioned them earlier, and I have a whole video about how to create them, but essentially this is a sheet that shows the artwork at actual size. It should list the actual size of the artwork, length and height, and just as important, the colors. So whether this is graphic artwork for screen printing or an all-over print or even embroidery, you'll need to specify Pantone or embroidery thread colors for each of the color positions in your artwork so that if you're sending this to a printer or embroiderer, they'll know exactly what colors you want. And of course, every printer is different and every monitor is different. So you can't rely on the printer printing out your artwork or the embroiderer viewing it and matching colors to the screen. Like your details on a tech pack, you need to specify exactly what you want. Unlike other documents that designers have to create, I've never created an APS sheet in anything but Illustrator. I'm sure you can, but whether it's just because this is all I've ever used or it's actually true, I think Illustrator is probably the simplest option. Now, of course, there are other things you can use Illustrator for: packaging, hang tags, technical sketches, meaning the detailed specification sketches you might have to include sometimes with your tech pack. Presentation materials. There's so much that one fashion company can get from using Illustrator, particularly if you're a small brand. It's probably the biggest bang for your buck that you'll get from any of the software you invest in. So I know that there's a lot of fashion software you can choose from these days. And then on top of that, there are these new AI tools. And I know we talk about all of it on this channel, but I've also mentioned in previous videos that it's not necessary, nor is it financially smart or productive for that matter, to use every single one. Obviously, you want to keep your eyes and ears open and keep watching this channel to see if there's something that's so amazing, it might be a good idea to try it right away. But a few good pieces of software is really all you need. And in my opinion, Illustrator should always be one that's part of your digital fashion software toolbox. Thanks for watching today's video. If you're new to Illustrator and need to learn to use it as a fashion designer, be sure to check out my beginner Illustrator for Fashion Design course. The link to the course, which includes a free preview, is in the description. Be sure to like, comment, subscribe, and share this video if you find it helpful. Have an awesome week, and I'll see you next time.